Hello and welcome to Affinity. One of the ways that we improve a picture is by sharpening it. And certainly in the past I've been guilty of several sharpening sins, if I'm honest. But one of those is I'll go to the unsharp mask, and I'll say I'll look at something like this house and I'll make that a bit sharper. So I'll turn it up and what's that? Bit better, it's okay. Say, whilst I'm looking at this, I'm missing one of the things that's happening up here is I'm getting a horizon halo. You might be able to see a bit of a white line there. So, if we zoom in a bit more, you can see what that is like. You can see there's a white line above the horizon, that's a horizon halo. And if we turn this all the way up, just for now, that's a real halo. And those things can just be a bit annoying when you miss them. So, what we can do to get rid of this is several things. One of the simplest things to do, although it does change the way that sharpening works, is to go to the blend mode and from here go up to darken here. And if I go onto darken, you'll see what happens. See if the line there disappears, so the white disappears, but also the whole sharpening changes. And it's because the way sharpening is done is it is finds edges and it puts a lightens one side of it and darkens the other side. And our horizon halo here is the lightening side, and we can see it's visible. It's not so noticeable down here, and we want to get rid of it. But if we use darken, it does take it away, but it also affects the rest of the picture. So that may work, it may not. But if we don't, say it doesn't, what else can we do? Well, what we can do is we can use masking. Because with the unsharp mask, we've already got on here a built-in mask. It's very, very simple to do this. To say, we want to say, don't sharpen this, sharpen everything else but this. And the way to do that is I go to a paintbrush tool and make sure I've got black selected, and opacity is usually sort of like somewhere in the middle, because you can have a couple of strokes at it, but you can experiment with that. But as I paint here, I'm saying don't sharpen in this where I'm painting, or at least not as much, because I've got 40%, then that's going to be 40% sharpening. So that halo, as I paint across here, disappears. When you've got a high-res picture, that can be a lot of painting, but that's quite an effective way of doing it. So, what else can we do? But supposing, and this is something I've done a lot of, I've effectively merged it, I've gone away, and I'd come back years later. And let's get a bit more here. Here we go, here's a bit of halo across here. And I go, damn, I need to get rid of that halo. What shall I do? And what I do is I go to the clone brush tool and I set the blend mode, which is up here, of this is to go to darken. So I'm using darken again. And I alt click up in the sky and then paint downwards across the horizon. Sometimes you need to paint in other things. And you can do this again you can change the opacity to make this. If you get any effects in the sky, you can paint around and get rid of them. But you will paint away that white line. See what that's happening there? We're just getting rid of it, we're painting it away. We're going to make sure that the line above here is not too varied. Otherwise you'll start to get effects that are noticed. So there we go. There's some ways of coping with the horizon, which has got a halo on it, the horizon halo, or you can get halos elsewhere, and you can clone and paint from the light side onto here, and using a darken blend, you can use a darken blend on the opacity originally, or you can do a sharpening and then use a mask and paint away the edges you don't want to be seen. There we go. Hope that was helpful, and thank you very much for watching.